So now today's topic is about how to make chemical equation more informative. In the previous lectures we studied about how to balance a chemical equations, how to make a chemical formulae and how to identify that chemical reaction has occurred. All this we have studied in the previous lectures. Now in this lecture, so let us study after writing a chemical equation, so how can we make that chemical equation more informative? So by the following characteristics we can make a chemical equation more informative, that is by representing physical states, by representing heat change, if there is a heat change, that is if there is a heat release of heat or absorption of heat, if there is a gas evolved or if there is a formation of precipitate and the reaction condition. These are the characteristics that we need to express along with the chemical equation. Now let us try to learn one by one. First, how do we express the physical states? How do we express physical states in a chemical reactions? So the physical states such as solid, liquid, gas and aqueous, these has to be mentioned along with the formula by a notation. Like if it is a solid, so we should express with a notation S along with the formula. Liquid L, gas G, aqueous AQ. So these notations has to be mentioned along with the formula. Let us take an example. Al plus Fe2O3 gives rise to Al2O3 plus Fe. So this is a chemical reactions. So this is what balanced. We need to balance it. After balancing the chemical reaction, we need to express the physical states. So aluminium is an element. It is a solid. Iron oxide is a solid. Aluminium oxide is also a solid. And iron is also solid. We are expressing the physical state solid along with the formula on a symbol. Right? With the notation S. Right? If there is a liquid or a gas, that should be expressed with L, G. And if it is an aqueous, any substance which is added with the water, that becomes an aqueous solution. So AQ, aqueous solution by AQ. So this is how do we express physical states. Now the next one. So expressing heat change. Generally heat change reactions are of two types. One we call it as exothermic reaction and another we call it as endothermic reaction. So what is exo and what is endo? So exothermic, it is a reaction in which heat is generated or heat is released. That we call it as exothermic reaction. And we call it as endothermic reaction is a reaction in which heat is absorbed. So here heat is released. Heat energy is released here. So here in this reaction, heat is absorbed. If heat energy is absorbed, we call it as endothermic reactions. And these reactions are represented or expressed. If it is an exothermic reaction, we should represent it with plus Q. Right? Heat change is represented by Q. If it is exothermic, plus Q. If it is endothermic, minus Q. And this plus Q and minus Q should be on product side. For example, C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. So it's an exothermic reaction. It should be represented by plus Q on the product side. Is it clear? Now this is carbon is solid, gas. We'll get gas. The next example, N2 plus O2 gives rise to NO. Right? 2NO. So it is also a gas. It is minus Q. This reaction is represented as endothermic reaction. We represented with minus Q on the product side. This is how do we express heat change. Hope it is very clear. Now the next one, gas evolved. The next one, gas evolved. How do we express the gas evolved during a chemical reaction? Now the next third one, gas evolved. So where do we came across this gas evolved? Yes, in the lecture one we studied in the activity 3. When zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid, it releases hydrogen gas. So if there is a release of gas in a chemical reaction, so how do we express this? So expression of gas evolved is expressed by an upward arrow mark. For example, gas evolved. How do we express? So gas evolved is expressed by upward arrow, zinc plus hydrochloric acid. So gives you zinc chloride plus hydrogen gas. Okay, so if there is a evolution of gas, if a gas is evolved during a chemical reaction, so we represent with an upward arrow mark. So this is how we express gas evolved. Next, precipitate form. How do we express a precipitate form during a chemical reaction? So what is precipitate? Precipitate is an insoluble substance which is formed as a product after a chemical reaction. For example, I'll put down the equation here. AgNO3 plus NaCl gives you AgCl precipitate plus NaNO3. So this is what we call it as solid. Okay. Now here AgCl is a precipitate that which is formed during the reaction between these two. So how do we express? We are expressing the formation of precipitate by downward arrow mark. Is it clear, students? That is how do we express the precipitate formed during a chemical reaction. Now some reactions, they occur under such a reaction conditions. So reaction conditions during a chemical reactions, they are expressed above and below the arrow mark. For example, okay, a process of photosynthesis, you all know this. Okay, so photosynthesis process, I'll put down the chemical equation. 6CO2 plus 12H2O gives rise to C6H12O6 plus 6O2 plus 6H2O. So it's a liquid, gas, solid, liquid and a gas. So here this reaction occurs in presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. So this is what the reaction condition. Now these reaction conditions are represented above and below the arrow mark. Okay, so that is what, and some reactions takes place in presence of catalyst. What is catalyst? Catalyst is a substance which increases or decreases the rate of reaction without undergoing any change. Okay, those are called as catalysts. So catalysts are represented above the arrow mark. Some reactions takes place in presence of sunlight, like photochemical reactions. That is, AgCl gives rise to Ag plus Cl2. Okay, is it clear? So this is what, this takes place in presence of sunlight. So this we call photochemical reaction. It is a type of decomposition reaction. So it is represented above and below the arrow mark. Okay, so this is what, how do we make chemical equation more informative. Hope this concept is very clear for you all. Okay, so that's it for the day, students. So I request you all to go through the lecture 1, 2, 3 and 4 of this chapter, Chemical Equations and Reactions. It's very important concept and easy chapter to learn it of our class 10. Okay, hoping so, this concept is very clear. If you like this video, children, please do like it, share it and subscribe it. Do not forget to press the bell icon to get the latest notification of our videos. Okay, thank you, students. Have a good day.